It wasn't the type of thing where we looked, went out and said, oh, we got to get a bunch of big name stars and be on our record. We actually made sure we kept down the amount of people that were on this record.
This album is definitely more matured. It's definitely darker and more patient, also.
How's everybody doing? Scott and Ken here from the Bomb Shelter here.
You have this like garage studio, right, called the Bomb Shelter?
There's a bomb shelter from the 61 Cuban Missile Crisis right in the front yard.
Success for us just finishing it and thinking we did a great album. We had a great album that we finished. It's weird because it all happened so slowly. There were little things here and there.
I mean, obviously Niall's Time is the pivotal moment. You know, the single, the 12-inch, 3,000 were made, 3,000 were sold, and we were like, wow, 3,000 people bought Niall's Time.
Like K-Rock playing our second 12-inch single, Keep Hope Alive, before the album came out, long before.
Keep Hope Alive and the success it had, you know, propelled us into the whole record deal and then the eventual album Vegas.
If you're not familiar with their name, you might have experienced the Crystal Method without knowing, lending their sound to spots for The Gap and Mazda.
Radio stations and other music outlets weren't prepared at that moment to play, you know, electronic music.
The driving force behind this game is the pulsating cyberpunk soundtrack featuring music provided by the Crystal Method.
Basically, touring was the most important thing, though. Getting out and playing for people.
Well, since the release of Vegas, we toured basically for 2.5 years straight.
We both grew up loving, you know, going to concerts, loving the whole, you know, experience, and so we make every effort to bring a good show to each, you know, city that we, you know, tour to.
When we were first asked to play, we just went around looking at all the other acts that were doing electronic music live, and we just thought it was really boring. And so that's when we decided that we wanted to make every one of our shows a performance, you know, and really play live.
We wanted to try to get that intimate feeling that we got when we saw our favorite bands when we were growing up. You can get the eye contact with them. You can see them playing their instruments.
So it's like every night a stress test.
I try to do my best to push those bad boys to the limit, you know what I'm saying?
He's gonna rebuild them on stage. First, we're going to call it 7-Day Tweekend.
It was taking forever for us to complete this record, and there was a joke that, you know, 7-Day Tweekend.
We've been working on the record so long, and it's just basically retweaking all the songs all the time.
Continuous retooling, adjusting. You know, we love playing with the different meanings and different words.
I think it's basically just building on his idea.
It's a wide-angle close-up. Basically on her face, kind of like this.
So then the shot would be of her sort of looking out at this horrific Three Mile Island thing with the water and the tumultuous sky. Come to find out when you look at the other shots that everybody is in this crazy world.
We just thought, we called the Crystal Method. Our second album's got to be called Tweekend.
Tweekend and Vegas are exactly the same, but completely different.
It still sounds like us. It still sounds like the Crystal Method. It sounds like our next album. But it doesn't sound much like Vegas. Much more of maybe a harder feel, maybe a darker feel. One of my favorite moments making this record was when we had John Bryan in on Over the Line. We have this old Wurlitzer piano. Really wanted to use it. I knew John would be into playing it.
We just had a beat going, and then he started playing this electric piano part, and then he had this vocoder kind of thing going, and we were just, you know, all of us had our things. It was like a well-oiled machine for about 10 hours.
Incredibly talented musician, producer, everything.
It's one of my favorite tracks that we've ever done.
So the other stuff, it doesn't bug me that much. I like doing interviews, I like doing press. You know, artwork, videos, photo shoots.
See the ducks? Get the ducks? Get my rifle? There's gotta be a body in there. There's gotta be a dead body in there. Looking at you?
What's so weird?
There must be seas, right, to a palm tree? There's bird shitting all over here.
Not quite ready for my close-up. Yeah, it's tough work. Get some! Yeah, that's right. You know, on this album, we've just been in the studio. We're working so hard.
Drop it now! Drop the pie now!
No, we just think we took it to the next level.
Get on your knees! Get on your knees!
PhD, that track might end up being one of the personally the most satisfying tracks on the whole album.
The sounds that you've never heard before, you wonder if that, what is that, a guitar, is that a synth?
It just sounds so great. There's so many great moments in that track.
I mean, we try to work 10 to 12 hours a day. We've been in here a lot lately.
When we're not in here, Blaine kind of takes over for us. He's working on a mix right now. Don't pay attention to this. This is the magic box. Now this is Spaghetti Island. Also our patch bay. It's called a chaos pad. When you light it, when you turn it on, it kind of looks like Star Trek control panel. This is something that's on every track we do. This is our Joe Meek stereo compressor.
Well, keep going. I wonder what that shit was over there. Miscellaneous distortion pedals. Got Boba Fett. It's actually pretty clean over here right now. I usually have quite a mess over here.
You know, I'm definitely more of the engineer, producer guy, and Scott's definitely more of the composer, musician guy. But I mean, we each take on all four of those roles. Yeah, our manager had some new ideas on recording and the whole studio experience.
And kind of, you know, give us a little jolt that would hopefully help us, finish the album. We were like a little hesitant at first.
No. You don't seem to understand. Hello, you listen to me, jackass. We're not only making the label happy by forcing a deadline, but you're involving the fan.
Crystal Method! Woo!
Yeah!
That's what we're all about. So I don't know. $400 or $500 a head. Equal parts theater, live sporting event. Picture it! I think this is gonna take their music to the next level. Really take it to the next level. I'm talking cheerleaders, I'm talking commentary, I'm talking crowd.
This is gonna be cutting edge, baby. I'm talking
revolutionary. This is, all the green lights are on. The pavement's already been laid.
This has to happen.
What do you think, Ken? Are you loving it?
What does Scott think? Does Scott love it? Ken?
Extreme Studio.
We're outside the Crystal Method studio, aka the Bomb Shelter. We're anxiously awaiting the arrival of the band, currently hard at work on their latest release. Let's take a look at some of the fans and their support.
Crystal Method is my inspiration for everything. I live it.
A good party today.
I've been waiting for this for like 3 months now, ever since I heard the record was coming out. I've been camping here for 2 days.
I just want to know one thing. Where's all the white women?
How about 24-7? The wife's getting all pissed off at me. The kids are bent out of shape at me. I just cannot get off it. I'm just waiting for it.